The jet lag session, since we've been in America since a couple of days, so we're still a bit jet lag. And this next one is it's called Shallow Life. Yes.
Shallow jet lag.
Shallow jet lag.
I hope I remember the lyrics. We played this when? We haven't been playing this for a while. I hope I remember the lyrics. And we wrote them. That's scary.
I leave a dream that's better.
so far. Are we doing good? Are we doing okay? By the way, we're gonna start Gigan Tour in a few days, so I hope you all are coming to see us. If not, we're gonna come back in a few months for a proper US tour. So hopefully we're gonna see you all. Hopefully you will learn the lyrics so you will be able to sing them with us. And they're talking, they don't care about me, just like
so they're debating.
Alright, it's time for
Closer.
Closer into deep, where there is something I wish for, I'll go through. Want to get closer into you, know how to discover. I've got it all inside myself. Salvation, you have bridged this gulf. No way you can turn it around. Looking for a higher ground. Searching for it, something is before. From a higher ground. When I fall in the right direction. Only the fire that's not. But I'll go through. Want to get closer into you. Know how to discover. There is just nothing to betray. Salvation, you have bridged the scar.
No way you can turn it
around.
Seeing a lot of smiles, so that takes away the moon head smoothness. I like that. What?
To myself, I turn.
Come on. Old school things. No, it's time for something new. It's time for something new. This song is from Dark Adrenaline, which is our new record out today. Buy it. Thank you.
You can purchase, you know.
It's a ballad. hopefully we're gonna do it good. We're gonna perform it today for the very first time, so who knows? It's a song called End of Time.
Yeah!
First test was quite good, right?
Yeah.
Say yes, please, because we have one more song.
Yeah, next one has been the first single out of the album, Dark Adrenaline, so maybe you heard it already. It's called Trip the Darkness.
A giant one.
Again, and I'm totally faded. what a day. I see beauty in every day, but the world is still fading away.
Come to me, come to me, I am waiting for you. Come to me, I can't wait.
Just in time, what a day. I can barely keep my eyes wide open. I don't wanna see straight, what a day. Seconds, minutes, and hours spill over. There's no time here in space.
Come to me, come to me.
Just in time,
just in time.
Obviously, the versions on the record are a little bit different. They're a little bit different, a little heavier. A little heavier. So, I don't know what's happening now, because...
More songs!
More songs. You're right. Sure.
Okay.
Angel's Punishment.
You win. Let's go.
All right, well, as you guys all know, we're streaming this live tonight, and just got a quick couple questions for you guys. First of all, thank you to Vintage Vinyl here in Jersey for hosting us.
Yeah, thank you very much for having us.
These questions came from your fans. They were posted up on the Metal Club Facebook page. So, first of all, you know, you want to tell us a little bit about your gear, your guitars, things like that?
For the acoustic shows or for live shows?
For both, yeah, sure, whatever.
Okay, for live shows, we're using gear endorsed by ESP guitars and Line 6 amps and cabinets. So we're actually playing now with our custom models, who is from ESP, and usually we have some spares guitars, GSP, but Steven Carpenter model, you know, the guy in Deftones. And about the amps, so we're using the Bogner, the Valve MK2 for live shows and cabinets as well. Today we were performing with the Ovation guitars. I don't remember the model. It's an
Elite. The Elite T. Yeah.
Sounds good.
Sounds good.
Whatever it is, sounds good.
Cool. Thank you, sweetie. Thank you.
Welcome. Christina, with your instrument being your voice, are there any type of vocal exercises that you do or anything to, you know, keep yourself sharp?
Okay. Well, whatever. I like yours. Come on. I have to say, and I mean, it's to get that we're pretty lazy. I mean, we don't exercise too much before every show. We're talented.
What are you saying? It's not true.
We play video games. We sleep. We watch movies. No, we have some little exercises we do before we go on stage, but it's not that we take like 1.5 hours. We close ourselves in the dressing room. We just go on stage just because we want to express our energy. So even if of course, technique is really important, and you have to save your voice. I think it's about the feelings you're trying to give to whoever is listening to what you're trying to, you know, sing during the show. And we have some little tricks for when we don't have enough voice or when we're sick. We like to drink. It's a mixture, and actually the recipe, we got it from the managers, a girl who managed Dio, who managed Manowar, so, you know, like big voices. And it's a mixture of lemon juice, honey, and ginger root, that it's really good to protect the throat, and, you know. So every once in a while, we just drink a little bit of that.
Or Jack Daniel.
A shot of Jack. A shot of Jack in case you're dead. But you can't really do it for more than 2-3 days. And sleep a lot, as much as you can.
This one came from David. He wants to know what the inspiration for the song Swamped was. He said it was the first song that he had heard and he loved, and he'd like to know more about it.
We wrote the song like 10 years ago, maybe a little more.
so we have to go back
a little bit, dig a little bit in the memories.
I don't remember what was the main inspiration back then, but we're usually inspired from what we're living. We don't really like to write about fantasy stuff or create stories that we cannot really know for real. So it was probably inspired by our life, but I cannot really remember the specific episode or...
Me neither.
No, I can tell. I remember, but I can't tell you because it's so deep. It's too private, so...
Alright, well, with the new album, how does it compare to previous Lacuna Coil albums? Any insight into that?
Well, there are a lot of differences. I think that the production, the sound that's coming out of the album is the main difference. We've never wrote an album so obscure and so heavy for our style. So that's the main difference. I can tell you a little bit of the thematics through the songs. It's not a concept album, but we definitely started from a dark moment of our life, because some members of the band went through not exactly happy episodes in life. Nothing too tragic, things that everyone is going through during life. The loss of a person you care for. You can split up in a relationship, you can move houses, and everything is chaotic. So we went...
This is exactly my story.
This is...
We never thought actually the album is about Mao's life.
So we put everything together. We started from a dark moment of our life to try to get out of it, pushing all the negative feelings out. And my voice sounds sexy here. It's different. What type? What microphone is it? Sure, of course. So we started from this dark space to, and we it's just getting downhill.
Game over. Let's go on.
Game over.
All right, next question. For the special artwork for the Metal Club exclusive, the artwork that's up here on stage, what was some of the inspiration behind that?
You can actually call the guy.
Yeah, actually, we got Marco, our bass player.
Maki.
If he's not at the bar, he should be here. It's here.
Parla di da dove ti sei ispirato per quello.
I'm a bass player.
Oh, Marco designed all that alternative artwork that we have. So not only the cover, but also the inside. So where did you take the inspiration?
It was the right moment. I was laid down in my bed, thinking. I just wake up and start to draw. I really don't know.
It's another personal story.
I really like to draw, so...
He's playing shy now, but is a great... It can draw really well. Is a great... is a very creative person. If you have a look at our official site, you can see all his drawing. And these drawings are going to be present in the special artwork. And even if he doesn't want to say it, we know it because we spent a lot of time with him. He basically stay awake all night long watching TV, turning the volume down and get inspiration from horror movies or just TV, what's happening. And then he just starts porn. Why not?
I'm getting old, so I need porn.
And then...
Thank you.
You told me that. You don't want to see it now.
Oh, yeah. That's good. Thanks.
You guys had mentioned about going on the Gigantour. What was this, kind of the feeling you guys got when you were asked to be a part of that? Any...
Oh my God. We've done Gigantour in a few years ago in Australia with a different lineup. It was Megadeth, Static X, Devil Driver, and Bring Me the Horizon. So we got in touch with the Megadeth camp back then, and then now this year, Dave knew we got a new album out, and so he asked us to be part of the bill, and we were very honored because we had a great time last time we did it in Australia. And so it was the perfect start for us to introduce the album to a lot of people and go through the radios, to all the promotion you have to go through once you have a new album out. So it was perfect combination to be in America again after a few years and start a great tour. So it's also an honor to play with Megadeth and Motorhead, which are two classic bands, of course, and also Volbeat that we just discovered recently. So it's going to be great, I think.
Well, unfortunately, we're going to be the first band playing, so 30 minutes after they open the door. So if you want to check us out, you got to be sure that be quick or be dead. Yeah.
Again, Christina, another question for you. Being the female front person in the metal world.
Oh no!
I know.
Not again.
These aren't my questions.
Not again. Just,
I know. Okay, I think that pretty much answers it.
I understand that this question made sense years and years ago when we started, when there were no bands, not so many bands at least, with a female in the lineup. But now there are so many bands with a female in the lineup that it's so normal. I mean, I never really thought as myself as a female in a band. I just thought of myself as a singer in a band. And so I never put so much attention into this thing. And I feel great. I mean, they're like brothers to me, so I feel part of the family.
And, the last question, the metal scene here in America, how is it compared to the scene in Italy?
I mean, there's absolutely no comparison because in Italy metal is very underground, and we're lucky that due to the success we had here or in the UK, in other places in Europe, we've been considered like an export product for Italy, so we got attention from different medias like TVs and radios that we normally would never had just because metal is not mainstream at all, unless we're talking about Metallica or Iron Maiden or, you know, all the bands that are famous worldwide and not just in Italy. So there are a lot of bands, there are little clubs where you can play, metal pubs, but not really a proper scene, nothing. That's why we are one of the few Italian bands that has been known out of Italy for metal.
All right, well, thank you very much, guys. Thank you again to Vintage Vinyl. Thank you to you guys for coming out.
Thank you very much.
Thank you as well to the fans across America who are checking us out on the webcast.
Thank you. Thanks to the Metal Club as well.
Thank you.